There's that one friend. That one friend that no matter what you do, no matter where you are, no matter what you're doing, that friend is there backing you up, always by your side, and that friend is God. Amen?
Amen.
And He's my friend. As a matter of fact, He's my best friend. God is a friend of mine. I am a friend of God. Some of these friendships, they become friends because maybe you're somebody popular. They become your friend because probably they want something. Or they become friends because maybe you're good looking. You know, I got a lot of friends. Well, maybe some. You know, if we're looking for a perfect friend, without fault, we won't find that friend. We'll probably, if that's the only criteria we're looking for, we won't have any friends. But God doesn't have that criteria. He looks past those faults. He'll take you as His friend, no matter what you've done, no matter what your past is. God is still our friend. The reason why Jesus came to make that friendship possible again by taking away the penalty for our sin, our rebellion, by dying in our place. In Paul's letter to the Corinthians, in his second letter to the Corinthians, Paul puts it like this: all this is done by God, who through Christ changed us from enemies into His friends. Okay, He changed us from enemies into His friends. Jesus had made this friendship possible because He loves us so much that He died for you and I. Greater love has no one than this, that He laid down His life for His friend. The key to the friendship with God is not changing what we do, but changing your attitude of what we do. Changing our attitude of what we do. So whatever you eat, drink, or whatever you do, do it all for the glory of God. Amen?
Amen?
People often ask or say, but I don't know how to pray. How do I pray? It's simple. First thing, say hi. That's all you gotta do, is just say hi. He'll hear you. Our friends always hear us. God's going to hear us. Just say hi. That's all you have to do. That's all you have to, how you can start. Again, Rick Warren, in his Purpose-Driven Life, he recommends what he calls breath prayers. A prayer that you can say in a single breath. Like a short, simple prayer like, you are with me. Help me. Thank you, Lord. You know, thank you for my lunch. Whatever conversation that you have with God, that's all it matters. He wants a continual conversation between us and Him. You know, becoming best friends with God, that's God's desire for you and I. You know, we become best friends of God through faithful obedience, through sacrificial love, by meditating on God's word, and through continual conversation. You know, so let me ask you, do you want to be best friends with God? I see a lot of heads being nodded. I want to tell you about a friend who wants to be your best friend. My friend loves me enough to want to spend eternity with me. He gave his only son to die for me so I could do this right here.